Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, the weekly look at the AMA market. I know I'm said last week I'm gonna be doing it on Saturday, but I moved it even day later to the Sunday because yeah, I was not feeling too good yesterday. Still trying to get wake up and get all the alcohol out of my body because on Friday we had so much to drink. Can't even remember what time I got home. I don't know. I know that I come home, I turn on PC to do some production on my clients. I have no idea how the fuck I did that. But for some I did it, I went to bed and everything was spinning and stuff and it was like, oh, a lot. So that's why I decided to skip it another day. I forgot to put out a tweet out for that. But yeah, I was just too crappy to do it. So I moved it one day and now feeling I'm not completely up for it again. Covered everything. Then another thing is that next Friday is gonna be not gonna be completely the last video of the market. Because after that I'll be away for 2 weeks. So the 28th will be the last one. So you're not gonna have a video on the 4th. You're not gonna have one on the 11th. The next one is gonna be back on the 18th of August. And I'll be back with the videos. I'm gonna be at least 2 weeks away. Week 31, week 32, I'll be away. Because I have holiday now. This is my first week of holiday already. So, normally I would be away already now. But everything's falling a little bit different this year. So, usually I'm sitting 3 weeks on the fair. This year it's gonna be only 2 weeks I'm away. I might even gonna do it less the fair because I'm not really interested in doing not interesting really to do it when they're open. I'm just usually sitting a bit there and nothing else, just doing in the morning a little bit of maintenance and nothing else, so I might gonna do it less, but they will understand that. Alright, market, there have been some dev blogs coming out about the new moon minerals, how that's gonna work out. You're gonna have multiple type of minerals coming out of an asteroid now. It's not like of an asteroid out of a moon. There's gonna be like the bullet chunk out that's gonna be exploded, so it turns into an asteroid field. Then you can mine that. You have like multiple types of moon materials that come out of it, and normal minerals. That's currently what they announced. So that's a thing. Multiple devlogs came out this week already, so it's gonna be a little bit interesting. There's a chance, of course, that the mineral prices are gonna come down, but I think the small amount is so small that yeah, that's not really gonna have effect. It's gonna be more interesting what the moon mineral is gonna do. Alright, let's get on with the market. Let's start with looking at this. Let's see what Tritanium is doing. Tritanium has been going up this week quite a lot. We came at the highs here, still at the 5-ish mark. Heading close to the 5.5, really. I'm surprised that this is still going up, but see already after it, we're already making a drop, so it looks like more supply coming towards the market. And we're dropping already just below the 5-ish again. It looks now and then that Tame is trying to go up. I think we are gonna go up more. If you look at the graph, you see the jumps ups and making drops again. And then a little bit later, gonna make another jump up that's higher. And it's coming down less usually. So, Tame is going with jumps ups. Oh, price. Uses my phone. So, yeah, that's looks like what's gonna happen here. I think it's definitely gonna head more at some point, hitting the 5.5 isk. Not a huge amount on the market here. 5.18 currently here for the sellers, and 4.85 next door, and 4.84. Yeah, that one is the wrong way around. Oh, it's the right way. So, 4.84 here in the hub, and 4.85 next door for Tritanium. Let me write that down. So we are slightly going up. Still keeping an eye on this. Ferrite then. Well, it is not doing too much. We've seen a little bit of a jump up here in the middle of the week, but pretty much for the whole week has been really stable. It has been quite stable for quite of a few months from, let's say, mid-March. It is quite stable. We've seen a little bit of downs and some ups on that, but on average it's staying pretty much around the CISC per unit. So staying a little bit below, a little bit above it, that's where Tritium is currently really nicely staying. So currently 5.1898, next door prices, there are a few up there, there's 50 million up there. And then here in the station we're sitting already at the 6.05 on Ferrite here. And for the buy side we're sitting at 5.75. I can say it's staying quite stable on the prices here on that. Exelon is still on the downtrend. It's looking really, really good. I wonder what's the lowest point is gonna be. I really wanna keep an eye on it. I might buy like a whole load in if my wallet allows it. Or my cop wallet. Oh, we're sitting now at, surprisingly today, really, really low at 62. Is there, so sitting quite low there. I don't know where it's exactly gonna go. 67. There's some jump up here, but straight away went down. See, it was a little bit flat in the beginning of the week. But basically, on average, Maxlon is still going down. I'm gonna expect Maxlon is gonna recover somewhere near the 60 again, where it was before. After it's been so high here, it was almost 80. I think we're just gonna go recover back towards the 60. That we're sitting already 65 on the sellers next door, 65.63 in the hub here, and then 60.69 on the buyers. So already hitting the 60 isk here on Maxlon price. So I don't know if this is maybe gonna drop more on the buyers, maybe, but for now 60 isk on buys is a nice price. But seeing how the line is going, seeing where it was before here, I don't know if you can even really see my mouse very well, but I think Maxlon is gonna come down a little bit more on the prices. Alright, next one up is Oxygen. Oxygen is still really, really stable, really stable for the whole week. Don't see any movements here at all. It's been stable from sending. Starting from March, we only had to jump up here in June a little bit. Huge amount that got sold here. Did push the price slightly down, but getting quite easy stable again. So it's behaving very, very, very well. Very nice balance on supply and demand here. Basically, it's been really balanced out for a long time, because pretty much for a whole year. Seeing the small movements here, pretty balanced out. Then we got a difference. Yeah, when I think one of the patches came out here. Oh, that was the roll call change, not mistaken here. And then I should write those things down. Then the drop, probably more supply towards the market. Then it stopped a little bit more supply. And after that, it came really stable. So, Oxygen, really stable price. Nothing to gamble on there. 49.93 currently on the sellers, 46.12 on the buyers. Price went slightly up. And next one is Noxium. Noxium is still making his jumps ups and downs. The jumps up are getting smaller and smaller, and the drops downs are getting staying pretty much the same, but are getting lower than the last one all the time. I've given it a chance that we're gonna hit 325 somewhere, or 300 maybe. We see already a data point here that's getting quite low on this, but not huge amount. See, there's a lot of price difference currently today. I think that's gonna be changed still. It's a lot of movements on that. 325 currently average price for today, so I think the buy is already heading for the 300 on this. But it is really slowly dropping in price here. 310 already for the sellers, but it's like 2000 units, that's nothing. 320 currently on the seller side here in the hub, 309 on the bias here. So we're slowly heading for the 300, and there's not too much in between it for to hit the 300 here. So it's dropping quite quickly here. I think in a few weeks, maybe after my holidays, maybe gonna see the 300, or maybe early on already. Then up Zynrud. Zynrud has been going up last week, even has been going up pretty much this whole week until the middle. We see some supply that got sold here, 11.5 million, just below the 10 million. You see straight away the price took a nosedive down. We had even a top price here of 1,387, but it's a really high price. That's why probably someone sold this supply, pushed the price completely down to 1,071. That's a big difference, but the amount that has been sold in 2 days' time is like 20 million. The normal average here is around 2 million, so it's way, way more than normal. And that's why we had this huge pressure on the price here. That has come down. Currently 1,080 for the sellers on Zynrud and 1,051 on the buyers. I think this guy just was like, I'm not gonna go below the 1,000 or 1,100 and stay on that. And he's just probably gonna wait for a bigger load. So yeah, Zynrud has come down, crossover huge sales. On that, but stay pretty much on the same price on the buyer side that was last week. See if we got the same thing on Megasite then, but Megasite was already coming down. Megasite has some jumps up here, five and a quarter million in sold there. It's a little bit of a spike, but it had basically no effect on the price. Yeah, I see also a few more days, a little bit higher sales amount, but price is staying really stable on that. Because it's not too much high, it's maybe twice as amount the normal amount that's been sold, but the price stay pretty stable. See quite a difference between buyers and sellers, but that's about it. Really stable on there. 1,329 currently on the sellers, 1,250 on the buyers next door, quite of a small amount, and 1,205 basically in the hub. So I think he forgot to set his range on that. That says pretty much stayed. No, it dropped quite a lot. Then we have the last mineral, morphite. It's already for such a long time, really stable. Cannot do anything. There's nothing here really to report about it. It's just staying so evenly supplied. 9,699 on the sellers and 8,900 on the buyers. In Izasa? Don't know about that statement, it's only 100 units. But in the hub, 8,604. That is really low. It's not record bottom prices, but the price is incredibly low now for morphite. If you need a lot of morphite, you should go for it. Just a wondering, just gonna check quickly in between it, if I know where to find it quickly. Ores. See what the compressed stuff is doing, if that's even on the market here. Is that the right one? No, it's the cockite, macoxide. See what this is doing. This is not doing too much. Really interesting how these lines are moving. This may be more interested. I did made a spreadsheet to see if it's possible to maybe buy this stuff up, but I haven't checked it out for a while. This is sitting around the 2 million, 2.1 million for a unit. I don't know how much you can get out of it if you refine it. I should figure that out. That might be also interesting to buy up, but it's really stable and there's not a lot here. So alright, let's keep on going. We're gonna go for the skills and stuff. We're gonna first start with the skill extractor, and this one is still going up a lot on price. It's not stopping yet. We're hitting the 400 million even this week. Or a few days. Yeah, that's today. We're sitting at 280 million. Really high price currently on these skill extractors. They're really popular suddenly. Sales amount are staying normal. Well, it's, you know, if you look really careful, you look here. See here, low price, a little bit higher sales amount. Price starting to go up, sales amount starting to drop. Price dropping, sales amount starting to increase again. Did not do too much on the price. Then you see the price is starting to go up and the sales amount are dropping a little bit. Then here, it spiked slight up here in the sales amount. And now it's starting to drop even more. It's getting quite low on the sales amount. So it looks like more, there's no supply coming towards the market and this is just keep pushing the price up at the moment. 380 to 400 million on average prices on a day are really high prices and it doesn't look like it's gonna stop anytime soon. 378 million next door in the Yves Mongol port. 396 million here in the hub on the seller side. On the buyers in 357 million in the hub here. There's nothing anything from next door. Next door it's price a lot lower on that, but still we're going up quite a lot on this price for these skill extractors. And the last skill injector. Of course these are still going up in price because they need to match up with the skill extractor. So these are also going up, sitting currently at the 800 million for a large skill injector. Price also keep going up as long as the skill extractors are going up. These are just going with it, keep going up on price. I'm gonna get seeing higher and higher prices here. Also here already 793 million currently on the seller, 793.8 million on the large skill extractor next door in the hub itself, sitting already above the 800, almost 810 million here in the hub for a large skill injector. On the buy side, there's just a new one that came in here a few hours ago for 764.1 million on the buyer side. And there's still a lot here. You have 40 units someone wants to buy, another 10 here, 48 there. There's so much demand for these. It's I think these prices are going to go up for a while still, definitely. Then the small one, of course, is will following the line of the skill extractor and the large one, because the small ones are coming from the large one because those are split up. And of course these are also going up in price. Currently already handing for the 170 million on the highest price pretty much a week ago. It seems to slow down a little bit. We're sitting at 160 million on the prices there. We came for 150, so it went only up for 10 million. I was gonna expect these to jump up even more. On that, let's see, what was the last large one for price? I did not put a formula in here, but I want to put one in. If you buy straight from one market. It was splitting up in small ones, yeah, in how many small ones. I'll quickly make a formula out of this. So I can see if they matching with this line. Yeah, it gives me only 30,000. Can you see only that on the large one? I have no formula in here. Okay, I don't know how many it was split up. Large skill injectors are created using skill extractors. It's standing on the bottom. To five smaller pieces. Okay. So I'll do this. Do that. There we go. Now I can see what it is doing. Small skill injectors to put on the market. If you split them up from the... Gonna keep in saying from the buy price here, I put 793.8 million in it then. For a small one, they should be worth like 158.7 million isk. if you split up the large one. So they're sitting slightly higher, they're sitting about half a million higher on that. So you can make like a half a million more out of it if they sell, of course. But the sales amount is sitting around the between 100 and 200 per day. So it's maybe not even a bad choice, because you can make slightly more ISK out of it than selling the large one. On the 59.3 million ISK on, this sell is currently 150 million on the buyers for these. Then we have Plex. Let's see what Plex is doing. And Plex is still going up in price. This is... Plex is not stopping. Just like the skill extractors and injectors. It's not stopping. 323,250,000 average price currently for Plex. It's gonna get slowly more realistic what they said before the change, that Plex might gonna hit the 3 billion for a month. It's started to get slowly real, this. 3 billion a month for Plex is just gonna kill for a lot of people the gameplay if it's getting this high. You need to make so much ISK on that. As an industrialist, I'm not gonna make that. Unless I'm gonna expand hugely, and I think I'm pretty much on my limit. So yeah, getting really high on this for Plex, it keeps going up and up. There's no stopping it. I do see here this sales amount are a little bit dropping. Starting from June, sales amounts are dropping a bit, but we're still going up on prices here. Even it dropped, it just keeps going up. On the sellers, we're heading towards the 3.5 million, 3.3 million currently on the seller side already. Still, it's just been all bought up, basically. So there's a lot of Plex coming in. Not a lot of Plex coming in. There's still Plex coming towards the market, clearly new loads coming towards the market, but it just disappears so fast. If we look at the line here, it's a lot of a 3.3, 3.4. 3.4, 3.4, 3.6, 3.6. There's a really, really good chance that we're gonna see soon that we're gonna head to the 3.6. We're even skipping the 4 million, 3.7, and then straight towards 10 million per unit. That's insanely high. If you head for the 10 million, just for the record to calculate that out, if it's gonna hit 10 million, then the Omega account is just not doable to pay for it, because that's gonna cost you 5 billion per month to have an Omega account if it hits 10 million. It's just, there's no option. So I wonder what's gonna happen. It's now going really, really high up. I really want to know what you all think about if this high prices of Plex and why it's so high. Of course, there's more uses for it, of course, now, but it's starting to get unreal. This is gonna, if this keeps going up, because I really don't have the money, real money to pay anymore for Eve. This might kill my gameplay here, for me, that I need to quit Eve. I can still make, of course, the videos, but that's the only thing that I can do then for me, is because it's gonna kill my gameplay. 3.3, 3.4 million. Currently on the seller side, 3.2 million on the buyer side. It jumped up all like 200,000 up compared to last week's price. Currently for Plex, for 500 Plex, you're gonna pay 1.6 billion ISK for a 30-day Omega account. That's a huge amount of money on that. Then next up is PI materials. I need to look at it, how my list is. Broadcast notes. What are you doing? Not doing too much, staying quite stable on prices here. You see buyers sellers difference, but that's about it on the difference here. So it's really, really still. We see huge amounts of being sold and stuff, but yeah, staying still, prices staying quite healthy on that. Still at the 2.3 million ISK on the sales, there's only one, but I think we are slowly starting to crawl towards the 2.4 on the broadcast note prices. But then again, not too many buyers, and they are sitting up 2.1 million currently on the buyer's price. The integrated response drones, like a few, I think 1.5-2 weeks ago, we saw a jump up here in price. It's staying pretty much at that price now, not doing too much movement on that 2.8 million on the high side, on the seller side, about 2.6 million on the buyer side, it looks like it. But it does look like it's trying to go up in price here. See the 20-day is still going up, the 5-day went really fast up here. You can now also see the 5-day is already like pretty much for the whole week trying to go up in price. 2.8 million currently on the sellers, 2.6 million on the buyers. Nano Factory is not really going up in price. We did have a jump up in price here. I think what I said last time, it's probably not gonna last, and it did not. And it went back down. Back down towards its normal price here. We see a little bit of jump up here. It's a really sharp corner on the price there on the 5-day average. But back at a normal price, it did not maintain its high price here. So straight away back on its normal price. Back to about 1 million, 1.1 million on the sellers and 968,000 on the buyers. Organic mortar applicators, are we seeing a small increase in price here? We already had one a little bit last week on the increase on price. We're seeing now it keeps on going. It has been going, at least for the last few days, it's starting to go back up again. We've seen also a huge amount of sales here for 1 day. 7,500 plus on 1 day, it's a huge amount compared to less than, well, around 1,500 per day. So that's a huge sales. Seems to be indeed pushing the price a little bit up here and heading up for a higher price. We see more prices on the buyer's side than on the seller's side. So I'm gonna expect this one to start increasing more in price. Pretty much 1.2 million currently on the sellers and 1.1 million on the buyers. Cursive computing modules are going the other way. But we had a jump up a little bit ago, about 2 weeks ago, a little jump on the price. But that is already recovering back down again. I don't know where this is gonna go. Sales amount of quite normal, and not gonna expect any huge movement here yet. Until there's some more info coming out about the refineries, then we're probably gonna see movement in all this stuff. I'm already preparing for it. If you watch my daily market and production, you know what I'm doing. So yeah, for now, price is quite stable here, back to normal price where it was before. 1.7 million currently on the sellers, 1.6 million on the buyers. Self-harmonizing power cores did make already a huge movement in a while ago, still staying on that high price. Yeah, still staying really stable at the 2.5 million per unit. Well, it came from 2 million, so half a million increase. Staying quite high, so people are still waiting for the price to get higher. And I do not... I do agree with them, because if the refineries is coming out, we're gonna need more high materials again for it. And then we're definitely gonna see probably not a huge jump up that we've seen last time, because we're already heading... See, last time it was around here, the engineering complexes came out. We saw a jump up. Unfortunately, I cannot see that anymore from what with the citadels was, but that also had a jump up. So people seem to be already slowly preparing on buying and stuff and making huge profit out of it. So price is going up, but staying quite stable for now for a few weeks on here. 2.4, 2.5 million currently on the seller side, 2.2 million on the buy side. There's a lot of twos in there. Stell Conduits. This is where I'm betting already on it, and there's already a lot of movement in here. I bought a whole load up in Jita, including a buy order. Bought up, I spent, to be honest, you see, I spent about 11 to 12 billion is currently in this. We're seeing a lot of movement in here. High price is currently here, 1.5 million. But I'm gonna expect this one to score up way, way more on this. Spending a lot of Isra, I might even spend more on this. But we see a lot of movement in here. Low prices are around 1.2 million. That's a really nice price to buy in for. But we see definitely people already jumping more on this and buying whole loads up. You can see supplies coming towards the market pretty much getting instantly bought up. With a limit of a price, of course, that they're gonna buy in. I would never buy it in for 1.5. I would not do that. Because if you look at the high prices here, you're not even gonna get a double return out of it. You're never gonna make that, but still, not. I'm not gonna buy for 1.5. I'm never gonna do that. But there's a really good gamble in here. I do agree with a lot of people that are doing this here, by the looks of it. I'm taking the same risk. So, still, contracts are making a lot of moves in. There's hardly anything on the market, so the market is pretty much bought out here. Staying at the 1.5 million per unit for this, there's not too much on the market. On the buy side, we're seeing it 1.2 million. Not billions, 1.2 million on the buy side. Wetware mainframe also sitting more on the highest side on the price. Also, here, definitely people starting to invest in this, going up in price. A lot of people are probably responding to this also with the new dev box coming out already about the materials. So I'm expecting quite soon to see dev box about the refineries itself. And hopefully also seeing quite soon on the test server. So jumping up to about 2.3 million currently on the, probably on the seller side. Stuff has been bought up here also from the market. You can clearly see here more buy-offs on the market that is pushing the price up already. It was really low, 1.9 million. Really good time to buy those in. Already jumping up to 2.2 million already. Basically almost half a million profit if you sell them now. But don't do it. Keep a hang on everything. That's what I'm doing too. So 2.3 million currently here on the prices. 2.3 million on the sellers, just above the 2 million for the buyers. Then we're gonna look at fuel. In fuel blocks, see what the fuel blocks are doing. Not doing too much. We're seeing a little jump up here in price for the helium fuel blocks. It came down last time, pretty much back at the 20,000 mark. We saw it now, just now, not a lot on the market. Currently jumping back to about 21,000 per unit. Little big huge seals here, big seals here, that one is pretty normal. There are a few spikes in here on the seals, so not too much on that. It's not too bad on here. Doing quite well. So a little bit drop and then we jumped up. You can see here, not too much on the market. We're sitting pretty much at the 21,000 per block on the seller's side and sitting at 18,500 on the buyers. Hydrogen fuel block are going down and making a huge drop down even to 19,500. What is a really low price here. It's not a bad price, it's a good chance to buy in. Definitely. Set up buy orders for it. Because this is a big jump. There's not even a change on sales here. Really, but it's just a huge drop here that it's making to 19,500. I don't know why, it's just too much coming towards the market. I'm expecting this. It's already a drop here and it's recovered up. But then we're making now another drop on price. 21,000 still for the sellers, but on the buyers are sitting also at the 19,500. Nitrogen fuel. It's a little bit some movement in here. We see really low points here at 23,800 on price and here a little bit lower at 21,700. We saw here huge movement here, jump up, then a drop down, huge sales on these fuel blocks, and price went straight away back up again. So it's pretty much 24,000 per unit. This one's staying really expensive, nitrogen fuel. Don't know exactly why it's staying that high, but it is for now staying at this high price. The sales amount are a lot less, there's less production on this, so that's maybe why it's staying a lot higher. 23,000 800 pretty much for the sellers, 21,100 on the buyers. Oxygen fuel is still bouncing up and down. It's still one of the fuels that is not stable, really. You see ups and downs all the time. You see, you have pretty much one to two high and two low per month. So every 2 weeks we see a high price and a low price, can be a little bit longer or shorter on that. But that's now what's currently the oxygen fuel is doing. Bouncing all kinds of ways up. From really low prices from 19,000 per unit to really high prices of almost 27,000 per unit. Bouncing a lot. If you can really gamble here for short term investments here marked. Buy low, currently today's price of course it's like sitting at 19,000, good opportunity to buy. And maybe 1 or 2 weeks later you can sell it again for, let's say here, for 24,000. So like 5,000 profit per block. It's currently, this one is really good for a short term investment to make some quick risk because of all the jumping out it's doing. 24,250 per currently for the sellers and 90,100 on the buyers. See already straight here, 5,000 difference in that. Then next up, normally I had drone parts. I just removed this out of the list. I thought there was not really much use to it anymore to look at it. Some stuff is so stable and everything else seems to be start stabilizing there. There's not really any interesting stuff to look at. So in this case, we're gonna go straight for the Tech 1 ships. It's the Caracal. After the huge jump up in price last time, heading for the 10.6 million, almost 10.7. Or on Caracal, we're now completely coming down back to a normal price or even a quite low price. We're seeing here 8.5 million or 8.6 million for a Caracal on average. We've seen a little spike here on sales. It was a good opportunity there to sell Caracals, of course. Currently on the seller's price, 9.2 million. Next door, we're seeing at 8.8, pretty much 8.7, even for a Caracal. Or there. On the buy, we're sitting at 7.1 million. But it's still the only Tech 1 ship I got. next up is the logistical ships from Tech 2 at the Bessie. Let's see if the Bessie is still staying so high on price. Bessie is still really high on price, but it is also still trying to come down in price. Still 220 million is not a bad price. On still a high price even on here for a Bessie. Bessie is just staying really high. After this jump up, still no new supply coming towards the market, it looks like it. For this, but it's not doing, it's doing quite well here. I see 260 million on the high prices here even. Even that still for this week, it's already is high for like pretty much a whole month. It's already really high on price and there's still no new supplies coming towards the market. I think people are doing really small bids, waiting for it to sell out and then putting another small bid on the market. I think that's gonna do it and it's keeping this price a lot higher. Still 245 million on the sellers and 193.5 million on the buyers. Guardian was also went up in price pretty much the same time when the Bessie went up. Bessie went a little bit earlier on than the Guardian, but the Guardian is not staying high on price. And it's time to drop. We're seeing even a really low price of 180 million currently for today's price on average. Can still change, of course, because the sales amount are quite low. Basically, there's only one sold today yet. But the average amount about 6. Let's say between max 10 usually per day. On the prices here, but you can see prices are straight away dropping down. This here apparently a lot of supply coming towards the market and it's just pushing the price down. Well, Bessie is staying pretty nice and high. Yeah, there's a lot of supply coming here towards the market on new Guardians. That's definitely pushing the price down, sitting at 200 million now even on the seller side and 179 million on the buyers. Oneros, one of the less popular ships, but still going up in price. After the jump up of the price here, about 2 months ago, so hitting the 200 million, we made quite of a big drop. Got really low some days at 110 million even, 120 million on prices here. And now we're seeing O'Neill's again jumping up in price towards the 180 million. That's a good price for O'Neill's. I'm surprised that O'Neill's is so unstable suddenly. Really high price, dropping really low, straight away in a few weeks' time going back up to a high price. A lot of movement in here. There was also a really good opportunity here to make some good profit out of it in a short term on that. So a lot of jumps up, now back towards 180 and maybe even going high depending on how much coming towards the market. It's definitely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 orders coming, new orders coming in here on the market. Is all like only one unit, so price is not gonna be so much pressure on it. 178.7.8 million currently for the sellers. There's one coming next door at 170 million. So that's basically one really good one to buy up and swap it back on the market here. 170 million on the buyers. Scimitar, still the only one that's not really responding to this. Basilisk, Garing, O'Neill's have so much movement in the prices. Except for the Scimitar. Apparently there's so much supply on the, for the Scimitar lying around that the price is just not going up. We do see a really small increase in price, but this is really nothing to worry about currently for Scimitar. I'm not gonna expect any jumps in price here. We see a small increase, might be just like this one we had here around May. But I'm not gonna expect any huge jumps up on this one. It's just too much lying around. It's just keep coming new supply towards the market. Still 189 million pretty much for the sellers and 156.3 million on the buyers. And we have Tech 3 ships. We got a Swords, the Confessor. Made a drop down and we're now going back up because there was a huge sales here. Straight away pushing the price back up again to about 45 million. 43.5 million on prices here. But already starting to drop. Not starting to drop, it's going up. Wake up. Going up in price. But we're going back down. I think we're going to get back down quite soon again because there's just a huge amount of sales pushing the price up. At some point we will slow down and start dropping again. Confessor, also this one, if you really want to active trading, this is a good one to put money in because in short term you can make some good money out of here. 41.5 million to 42 million in the hub on the seller side and 35.1 million on the buyers. Hecate, not really any movement here on the price. It's really slowly going up in price on this, but not any big movements here on that side. It's surprisingly that these 20 days suddenly makes a drop here. It's probably responding to this drop here just now. We'll start recovering somewhere on the next week following the 5-day average. 39.8 million on the sellers and 32.7 million on the buyers. Jackdaw was going up in price, still hit a high price of 48.5 million is on the Hecate. But we're seeing now that the price is starting to drop. Sales amount for pretty much the whole week is quite low because the price is so high. We're now definitely going to see a drop in the price here for the next week. So this is really one, again, keep an eye on it because it might get really low on prices and it's going to be a good opportunity to buy in. 47 million currently on the sellers, 38.1 million on the buyers. Swiftpool, starting to stabilize again this week. Early this week it's starting to come down in price, came a little bit lower down than we are sitting now for pretty much the whole week. Looks quite stable here currently on this. Also not really any indication that this one is going to go up in price. Market, 37.5 million currently on the sellers, 32 million on the buyers. Tech 3 cruisers. This is still gonna be really interesting what the prices are doing. Legion has come down quite substantially on price. From a high price back to 140 million. It's higher than it was sitting on before. Seeing also again now we're starting to increase in price. See the sales amount has gone up so much. But I'm trying to fit out the Legion. I cannot find a good fit on DPS for this thing. Just for redding. Because you need a tank also. I cannot find a good fit on this yet. Plus I'm looking at EFT. Out of date. No use. No use anymore. So yeah, I cannot really figure it out. I'm not really a good one on making fits. So, but yeah, looks like it's starting to go a little bit up in price, but it might get a jump up. It is definitely not going to be as high as this for a Legion. Pretty much 160, 160.2 million for the sellers and 136 million on the buyers. Then the Loki is also coming down on price, but is starting to slow down on the drop. We might gonna stay a little bit higher on the price for a while. We see definitely here the sales amounts are quite high, but definitely push this price up. I'm not sure if we're gonna come back towards a normal price. They're apparently now really, really good cloaky ships with a lot of DPS. They're really dangerous on that part. I've seen that someone doing those fits just before they came out on the test server, and they are really, really good. So yeah, coming down on price towards the 160 million, still higher than they came off from. Still a really good profit if you buy it in cheap here, so like someone did here. So really good profits there. 165.9 million currently on the sellers, 150 million on the buyers. Proteus is still not a lot on the market. Proteus is going back up on price. This is the first one of the tech trees we've seen going up on price again. It was already went up high, but not as much as it used to, as the Legion and Loki. It came down quite quickly again to quite low price even. But now again, Proteus is starting to increase in price. 150 million currently. I think Proteus is gonna get a second bigger jump up. It's my feeling. Not sure if it's gonna happen. If it depends on the supply comes to my market. But if there's a low supply coming towards the market, I can expect this one to jump up even more. It was 170, maybe 180 million. I give it a quite good chance on that. Still, there's hardly anything on the market. You can see really quick it can go towards the 180. But there's quite a decent one here of 150. Currently sitting pretty much around 148, 149 million for Proteus. 116 million for the buyers. Tengu. Also, this one is starting to make a second jump up, but this doesn't look like it's gonna push that hard as the Proteus. Cross Proteus, Blaster Fit, Tengu, Missile Fit, that's a little bit of difference in there. I don't know if a Tengu now with whales or blasters is a good fit. I have no idea about it because it's basically, they mainly been used as a missile ship. But I have no idea about whale or blaster fit, how good the Tengu is gonna be in that. Definitely you're gonna run into one, you're gonna be surprised, that's for sure. But it is going to jump out, sitting at the 140 million now. I think this is gonna be indeed another second jump up on price here. I'm surprised the sales amount are a little bit high, but not as high as it I expected. Really, so still not doing bad on price here. 147.7 million currently for the sellers, 124 million for the buyers. Then let's look a quick look at Moon Material, see if anything interesting is happening. Crystal Carbonite had some jumps up, but it's already coming down on price. The Phenmonic Condensates made quite of a big drop in price here. It was already really high, dropped to about 70,000 per unit. But it's already recovering a little bit back up again to a high price of pretty much almost 87,000 per unit. Had some jumps up, but this is not really a popular one here. It's for sales. If you look at the sales amount, there is so little amount, 355, 11,000. So really those that should be more in Jita. Still, they're getting sold here. There's a little bit of movement in here again. Fahrenheit Carbide really stable, very very slowly on the drop. Froggle is also on the drop, coming from now from a really high price, and now is steadily starting to drop in price on this side. Fiedelrides also on the drop in price, heading for 734 average price per day. Can expect this one to drop more on the next week. Hypersynaptic fibers are starting to make a jump up in price. That's also one of those that I have a hard time getting in when I need it, because prices are keep going up on that. So it's jumping up. Don't know where this is gonna end. I don't think it's gonna be another big jump. This might be just a one day highest on that. Nano transistors are back up again. A huge up even early this week, up to 7,200 per unit. What is a really really high price for that? The high price was here this year, 6,450 on the average price. But they had even a higher one here now this week. Huge sales or so. Yeah, almost 3 million on one day, or normal amount sitting around 250,000 per day. That's a quite high jump up for price. Price already come down to 4,300 on average. But that's a big jump up in price, and on the seller side we're sitting around 4,200 per unit, 3,700 on the buyers. Non-metal materials did make a jump up last week and staying quite stable around 25,000 per unit. Pretty much whole flat line on there. Phenomic composites, also here, big spike on sales, 7.7 million on a day. It's like 5-6 times more than normal on there. Not really having a huge influence on the price here. Photonic metal material staying really stable on price for the whole week. Little bit of a jump up here because of sales amount. Plasmonic metal material, same story, really flat on this line here too. Not any movements there. Ceramic fibers quite high on price, hitting here 1 year high price, even 490 per unit. But not doing too much now. Not sure where this is gonna go. It's staying quite stable on price here for the last 3 to 4 days. Ferrous metal materials. Yeah, there's a high price here and a really low price here for today. Cannot tell where this is gonna go. On average, I think we're still slowly gonna drop in price. Yeah, it's sitting quite high for the time of year compared to here. So, but I think we're. I give it a chance that we're gonna drop in price here. Titanium carbide, a little bit higher on price than normal. Looking at this, 189 currently on the average prices. Yeah, not gonna expect anything special here. Tungsten carbide. Tungsten carbide made a jump up this week on price, came up to 179 on average, staying here for 3 days, 164 on average price. After that it came down to 144 and now going back up again to 157 on average. Some movement in here on prices, not a huge amount of margin in here. Only really useful in huge quantities on this. And there's decent supply coming towards the market. Two new ones coming here. This is a few days old. Same as this one is a really old one. There's some movement in here, but I'm not gonna expect any huge jumps yet. There's a chance still, because you see a lot of times a really short one day high prices and then straight away they're coming back down. Alright, this was this week's look at the Amar market. So we'll be back next week on a normal Friday at least. I will be back then again with the market. Also, I'll be live after downtime with my daily market and production. I got all my tech tool production is done. So I have a lot of stuff put on the market. So I'll be live after downtime on Twitch and YouTube. So you can watch me there if you want. If not, I will see you next week here on the video again. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you like it, please leave a like. I really like the likes to having that. My channel is starting to grow really a lot lately. Really quickly. Even like yesterday with streaming, I had like 5-6 subs with it and one follower on Twitch. So hope you like it. Leave a like or a comment down below if you want something to change or giving tips. So thanks for watching. And fly safe.